Spring practice at the University of Tennessee less than 2 weeks away. I'm Bob Kesslinger of the Vol Network. Pleased to be joined by Tennessee's offensive coordinator, Mike DeBoer. Exciting time for you trying to learn where the players fit and how you're going to get spring practice settled.
Well, very much so. I've been working on it since day one, so we're getting close. Somebody asked me the other day about, you know, what would you do in third and one? I said, we haven't gotten there yet. We're out in the field right now, which today we went over third and one, so we're getting closer.
You took the job and basically had to learn the players first, I would guess, or do they have to learn your system first? How does that work?
No, that was one of the things Butch really wanted, was somebody to come in and really take off with what was here. And obviously you add a little bit, you subtract a little bit, you know, but majority of what they did in the past is what we will be.
A lot of people talk about terminology and those type of things. Have you changed the terminology much?
No, not really. We looked at a few things that we thought, because we're no huddle, that was getting repeated a lot throughout the course of a season. So we took those terms and we changed those terms, and that would have been done anyway.
Your association with Coach Jones goes back to your Central Michigan days. Do you remember the first time you met Coach Jones?
Yeah, I do. It was at a basketball game, my son's basketball game, and he was a friend of our quarterback coach, Stan Parrish, and so Butch was stopping through and recruiting and was at the basketball game, and we met, and we went up kind of in the rafters, started talking football, and the relationship started ever since.
Started drawing plays on the rafters,
started
stuff
talking
like
a lot.
That.
Yep.
What impressed you about him when you, of course, you hired him as an assistant when you were at Central Michigan as head coach?
Right. A lot of times when you hire somebody in that role of offensive coordinator, it's going to be somebody you know because of trust, and you know how they coach, you know how they relate with players and all that. Well, when I went to Central Michigan, I knew I was going to put Butch in that role, but I'd never worked with him. So we had built that relationship through those years, and I watched him coach, though. I watched him coach at Michigan at the football camps in the summertime, and I just saw a guy that had great passion, had great relationships with coaches, players, and you know, I wanted him in that role.
And he was always moving fast.
That's right, fast and furious.
So when Butch left and started his head coaching career, did you stay in contact with each other?
Oh, yeah, we've always talked. After we left Central Michigan, we always talked all the time on a regular basis. And it was a lot of times it was just a lot of football questions, technique questions or system questions or, you know, areas of the field. I mean, we just continued to ask questions back and forth.
There's always a special bond between an assistant coach and a head coach. And now this role's kind of reversed a little bit. How has that been working out?
Well, my wife said be aware of karma. So it's been great. I always had the greatest respect for him and the role that he had and that he has now. And, you know, I think vice versa. So it's been outstanding.
You, of course, have been a head coach and a coordinator at a very high level at Michigan. How has that helped you now kind of see the big picture here at Tennessee, putting this together?
Well, I think you always have. There's some comfort and confidence in when you've done something in the past. And I go back to a lot of the ways that I did things before because they were successful. And yet also, too, I'm open to change as well. So it's been a great transition so far. And a lot of that has to do with the players here really accepting me as well as the coaches. I mean, I walked into a staff room where I knew Coach Mahoney and Coach Azani. I knew those guys from talking football in the past. I'd worked with Mark Elder. I didn't know Robert, but that room has been so accepting of me, and I really appreciate that.
Coach Jones's staff has been very tight-knit.
Yes.
Wherever he's been, and
right.
So now you walk into a room, and I guess for you it was nice knowing that you knew some of those guys.
Yeah, and on defense, I had worked with three of the four guys. So this staff I felt very comfortable with, and it was, even when I came in for my interview and stuff, it was a great fit from the start.
Offenses are always changing.
Right.
There's always a different look. You were in the pros for a while in the NFL. So your college experience, your NFL experience, how has that made you a better coach, you think?
Well, I just think that, you know, as you mentioned, everything is changing through the years, and I've always tried to change, and I've always tried to look ahead of the change as well. And so I just feel like, you know, staying up on the new wave of football has been very important to me. And, you know, and plus we've got a great staff that does that as well.
The new wave of football now is up tempo, no huddle, get to the line of scrimmage and try and get matchups that you like.
Right.
Explain that philosophy a little bit. A lot of fans don't think you just run plays, but you're actually looking for specific ways that you can take advantage of a defense.
Well, without a doubt, and when you look at matchups, you know, what is good for us is that we have an X receiver and a Z receiver. And so you can look
explain
at
that one to the fans.
X is like a split end,
okay,
who's always opposite the tight end. And then a Z receiver, depending on what you how you line up, but a lot of times he's on the tight end side. So we have that. And then we have the W receiver, who is sometimes to the X, sometimes to the Z. But by formation, I know where they're going to be. And so does our offensive staff, our players, everybody. So when we look at matchups, our matchup, our best matchup, it may not be maybe our number one receiver on their number one guy. We may be able to change that up by formation and get that, but if not, if they match us, which means they put their best on mm-hmm. our best, well, then our next best matchup may be our number two guy, whoever that may be. It may be a receiver, back, tight end, whoever. But now we can look at who our number two guy is and how we can get matchups that way, and then how we're going to exploit that by concepts in the passing game.
And your quarterback has to get to the line of scrimmage and see this in about 3 seconds.
Yeah, he's, yeah, without a doubt. And what I really like, though, is I like the fast tempo stuff because number one, it makes our quarterbacks think fast. And when they are thinking fast, they're going to play fast.
Josh Dobbs, very intelligent young man. Talk about how he's picked up this system that you're trying to put in.
Well, he has done a great job in the past with that in a short period of time. And I just, you know, when I came here to interview, I told him that I thought his stance was too wide. I thought he needed to narrow it because he would false step at times because of a wide base, which any football player does that in any position. And then I talked to him a little bit about his lead foot, about it was closed at times. And when he was then throwing the ball, he would pivot on it, and it would really take his hips out of line in the pass and who he was throwing to. I come back, I don't know, 10 days later, and we go out for skill development, and he's already corrected it. And that just, I mean, a lot of times it takes, you know, anybody a lot of reps to change
things. Because they've been doing it for
things.
Years.
Yeah, and so he had to train his mind, his body, everything. And just for him to do that so fast was very, I was very impressed.
Yeah, well, indeed, and he's a very intelligent young man. Tight ends in your offense. Tight ends now are hybrids, and they're H-backs, and they're fullbacks, and they're wide receivers. How important is a tight end in this offense?
Well, very important. Number one, we start off with their blocking. I mean, they've got to be tough guys that can run block. And then they've got to be skilled guys that can really do a great job in matchups with linebackers, as you talked about earlier, but to be able to take advantage of that. So they got to be skill and fast as well. It's a tough position to recruit.
And if you get one, you use them, don't you?
Oh, without a doubt. You have to. I mean, because of the matchups and all the things that they can do.
And tailbacks now in this offense, a lot of people think we just give them the ball and see if they can run.
Yeah.
They got to block, they got to catch, yeah. They got to pick up blitzes. I mean, you got to be pretty versatile as a tailback in this offense.
Without a doubt. And, you know, that's one thing I looked at when I looked at the tape before I came is, you know, I watched Hurd in his pass protection. I told Butch right away, I said, wow, that kid's tough. And, you know, I didn't know him at the time, but he impressed me in the pass protection part of it.
You are low in numbers at tailback. Jalen Hurd will be kind of limited this spring. Alvin Kamara is coming in. Talk about what he brings to your offense, you think, you hope.
Yeah, it's been hard to tell so far just because of skill development. You know, you're not, you don't have a football out there and you're not running plays, things like that. But what really impressed me from the start is that he's really smart and he really is into football. He's got a high passion for football. So I like that already. And then obviously he's got good quickness and speed. And so I'm obviously very impressed by him.
Your receiver corps is kind of banged up, but you've got numbers there and you've got a lot of talent. And I guess more importantly, you got a lot of size, which I think you like.
Right, I do. I like obviously speed and size, especially in this conference. I mean, that kind of defines this conference is the size and speed of it. But I like our receivers a lot. And the, you know, and Zach does a great job of coaching those guys out there. And I just got to, once we start practicing, I'm just going to get a better feel every day about what the things they can do in the passing game.
Is that, again, a trend in college football? Everybody's looking for that 6'3", 6'4", wide receiver who can run?
Without a doubt, but they're hard to find.
They are.
So,
but well, you can find it, but they got to be able to catch the ball, too.
Yeah,
that's
exactly
the other
all
aspect.
That, yeah, but we're very fortunate to have the guys we have.
You got some talented guys, and you have depth there, and that means competition when you get to fall camp.
Right, yeah, and that, you know, competition's what makes a team better every day, so.
So explain to the fans a little bit what you've been doing the past month since you've been here. And it's not just, you've been grinding every single day trying to figure out how this is going to fit together with spring practice just around the corner.
Yeah, well, we've been involved with recruiting, and we've been going through and evaluating kids at all grades. So it's not just, this upcoming class. We've been looking at everybody. And also I've been involved with all the offensive players, evaluating them as well. And then I've got states that I'm also responsible for, so I've been doing that. So we've been working hard at recruiting. And then the football side of it is that I just have been studying tape, been talking a lot with our coaches, really been talking about our identity, what we're going to be. And so every day we're trying to define what our identity is going to be on offense. And so just been working hard at that every day.
You know, one thing you told me that I thought was fascinating, you've gone through every single play of every game last year to evaluate how it was operated, how it was performed, how it was executed, and if it's something you should keep in the playbook. I thought that was fascinating.
Yeah, and obviously more with Josh Dobbs at quarterback.
Yes.
I spent more time with those plays. Because I think that, I really believe offense is about execution. And if you have too much, it's hard to execute. And we're starting off day one, and we're going to take our time because we want to be great at what we're doing, and we'll continue to expand as we go.
You've kind of seen Tennessee from afar all these years,
right?
And your days in the NFL and up at Central Michigan, at Michigan. Now you've been here. Kind of give us your thoughts about where Tennessee is.
I think there's one word that defines Tennessee football for me, and that's passion. I mean, everywhere I go, the people are so passionate about football here, and I love that. I love the passion that they have. I love the passion they have for Coach Jones, the players, everybody, and the entire program. So I would have to say it's really been eye-opening for me to say, wow. I mean, it's awesome.
And I would think you've got to be just, your battery's recharged, you're ready to go, and I know you're excited about getting this challenge in spring practice, finally getting here and getting on the field.
I am. I'm excited. I get a little bit of that when we go out for, some of our workouts right now, so I'm getting a little bit of that. But there's nothing like getting out on that field when you're blocking somebody and you're throwing that ball. It's just, to me, that's the way to go.
Well, as an old offensive lineman, you also like to run the football. Everybody talks about the spread and throwing it around.
Right.
But the if you're going to have a good spread offense, you've got to run the football.
You have to. And I really believe in today's football, and it's not going to change in the future, you've got to be able to do both. And to be a championship team, I mean, there's going to be times we have that lead late in that game, and we've got to be able to run the ball and have high percentage possession type passes to keep the chains moving, keep the clock running. And so that falls right back on the running game. And I think you got to be very efficient that way.
And spring practice will be interesting with the offensive line. You got all the starters back, and then you got a bunch of young pups,
right,
that think they can play too. So that makes great competition.
It does. And what we're going to do is we want to find, number one, who are the five best. And then whoever the five best are, then they've got to be able to play those five positions. I don't want number five sitting over there behind, say, the left tackle position or the left guard position. That number five guy's got to be in that starting five group. So that's another thing. So we're going to be moving guys around quite a bit, but we've got smart guys there that can do that.
Coach Mahoney also insists that all the players know all the positions in the offensive line, so that does give you some versatility.
It does, and that's very important. And obviously it's important to them too, because now they get to compete at all those spots, so it makes it better for them.
Spring practice almost here. It's a very important time for this football team, I think, moving forward.
Right. I mean, for all of our entire team, I mean, it's competition. There's nothing better than in spring practice. Everybody's going to be competing for that position, and also special teams as well. So it's great to be able to really, I think, kind of set an identity for your football team. And coming out of spring practice, you'll know that.
Coach, thanks for your time. Good luck in spring practice, and it's great to have you here.
Thanks, Bob. Thanks for having me on.
Mike DeBoer, Tennessee's offensive coordinator. And again, the Dish Orange and White spring football game will be on Saturday, April 25th at Neyland Stadium. Hope to see you there.